Okay, so on the day of filming here, it is Keith Richards' birthday, so put on a little Stones, I guess. So you can see the eject button works fine, door drops out. Okay, I'll take us in close to the counter. So you can see that is functioning properly. I'll hit reset here, take us back to all zeros. Counter's still turning. So pause the cassette. Back to play. Just feel the Dolby noise reduction there. So that's type C. And type B, I'm not sure if this was cassette was recorded with Dolby or not. I'll show the kind of reverse here. So you saw the tape counter did reverse. Okay, I'll take us to the end of the cassette just to demonstrate the auto repeat works. Okay, so it should be hitting the end of this side of the tape soon, at which point it'll stop, auto reverse, and then start back up at the beginning. Okay, so there it stopped. Now it's rewinding the tape. So the cassette well. Well, it's a pretty cool feature. You can tell how far through the side of the tape you are by how far over that light moves. So you should be seeing it shifting back to the right as the tape rewinds. can see the counter going in reverse here. Okay, so the tape fully reversed, and now we're starting up again. Okay, and our music's back to going. Okay, now I'll demonstrate the cassette kind of recording and rewrite function. So I have this cassette, rewritable cassette here that I previously just recorded the radio on. So I'll just play that. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is I'm going to just clear what I had previously recorded off here. So we'll stop and just go to the beginning of the cassette. So I have nothing coming through my receiver. So we'll record and play. And that should clear off all the old recording. Yeah, not really through on video here. Okay, so I'll just take us to the beginning, play that back just to show that it did clear the old recording. Okay, so you can see we have no sound, so it did managed to clear out that tape. Okay, now what we'll do is I will turn my receiver up here to the FM input. So, okay, so I just turn the tape monitor off so it's not playing into here. And this is not playing, so kind of prove that. Tape monitor back on. We still got no sound. And I guess that's where I stopped that clearing. Okay, so to the beginning again. Now we'll record whatever's kind of playing on the radio here. So try and find a station with some music rather than just recording a commercial.
Bring home the country.
Turn up the country.
92.5 XTU. We'll be right back.
Okay, switch the station again. If I can find a station.
Gives it a pretty good shot. Stoops will try to fire it back to the line, failed to do that. Kachuk gets to the loose puck behind the goal, carried it into the right wing corner. He'll leave it there for Josh Norris. Kachuk goes to the front of the net. Now back out to the blue line they go. Point to
okay,
point.
So we got some hockey on.
Catching up to that is Cam Atkinson. He's had two shortings this year. Stuffs the backhand. Oh, no, and it goes wide of the net. Has he been for his third?
Okay, so I think that should be enough. So let me just play this. Turn my tape monitor on so we get the playback through the tape player, and we should hear what I just recorded on the radio.
The Delaware Valley to buy from us.
I'm Jeff Allen.
So we got our commercial there. You got me changing the station. We got our country music station tuned in. Again, I'm not touching the receiver. Just to kind of prove, we'll rewind and play that country station intro again.
Fire lease your new Subaru now. Taking your order.
Okay, and we can fast forward a bit and see if we can find our hockey game. And there's our hockey game again. And we pause this, and it pauses. Okay, so as you can see, this Nakamichi CR-1A is in perfect functional condition. It both plays and records flawlessly. So if you have any questions, please reach out. Thanks for watching.